Hello everyone. I'm going to discuss the one of the important topic of administrative law in the unit 1 in chapter 1. This particular topic is mentioned and the name of that topic is rule of law. Rule of law, if you're talking about the term rule of law, means how the law work. Before that, we have to understand what is law. The law means some rules and the regulation which are law. Actually, the law is a term which is given to the certain rules and principles for maintaining the society. These are certain kinds of rules and regulation which are really required to maintain a society, people of the country or the nation. So there is a proper rule and then there should be a proper rule of law, then how this entire country should be maintained. Because as we all know that India is a diversity. India have a diversity, different kind of religion, different kind of faith of people, different kind of geographical distribution. And there's so many things entirely are different, things are available in such a whole country. So there should be some guidelines which are required to maintain the society, because if there is no any specific rule, if there is no specific guideline, then it's really very impossible to manage the entire country. So this is all about in this particular chapter. We are going to discuss the term rule of law. If we are talking about the term and what is the proper definition of this term and what is the exact legal meaning of this law, so in Indian Constitution there is no any place where this term is clearly explained, that what is rule of law. Though the Constitution itself doesn't say about the rule of law, but by the so many provisions of the Constitution, the term, the meaning, the intention of the rule of law is clearly mentioned in the Constitution. But this specifically, this term has been coined by the Indian judiciary time to time, and the rule of law word has been derived from the Indian judiciary in the very judgments. What is rule of law? If we're talking about the rule of law, is the basic structure of the Constitution, how the country run, how the people of this country can manage, how the people of this country can be operated in a certain specific geographical distribution. Rule of law has been declared by the Supreme Court as one of the basic features of the Constitution, so as to cannot be amended even by the constitutional amendment. So this is now the term is such a have a large impact on the Indian democratic setup. Even this word cannot be, even this meaning cannot be amended by the Constitution. It was clearly mentioned by the Supreme Court. Rule of law is seen as an integral part of good governance. Yes, I explained that for every country, if we're talking about even our house or anybody's house, if the person wants that his or her family is run, manage all the things in a proper, then there should be some guideline. That's it. In the same manner, if the country, if any democratic setup want to be maintained in a proper way, then there should be some specific rule of law, then how these things will be happen in the any situation. So now we are going to discuss the concept of rule of law. The derivation of the phrase, the rule of law, is from the French phrase, la principle de legalité, which implies principle of legality. That means the principle of legality, it means that anything if we supposed to do, if the government want to do, if the legislator, if the executive or either judiciary, then it must have some legality. It must have some base and what ground they are doing such thing. The term also coined, the term also discussed by the Archana, the concept of rule of law, on the idea of justice, fairness or inclusiveness. Justice, these are the basic principle of rule of law. Justice, fairness and inclusiveness means any action of any administrative authority or any state or any authority, the in any and their every action, these three things should be mentioned here. These three words should be implied in that action: justice, fairness and inclusiveness. This is the basic concept of the rule of law in which these things are here. Now, if we're talking about the meaning of rule of law, no man is above the law. and also that every person is subject to the jurisdiction of the ordinary courts of law, irrespective of their position of law. This is in our country, this is the basic policy of the rule of law, that every person is under the law. Whatever the law has been provided by the, either in the form of substantive law, either in the form of codified law, either by the legislature, every person is bound to follow that law. And if anyone want any kind of relaxation, then that must, if the law permits, then that relaxation will be get. It means whatever the rank, whatever the position the person have, they all are under the law. No man is above the law. In other words, as per the Article 13 of the new constitution, rule of law is mean law of land. This is the place in which the constitution of India not specifically mentioned the rule of law, but in their the language used in that article would clearly mention that rule of law means the law of land. Law of land means the law of land is constitution. Whatever the constitution suggests, that is a rule of law, and no, every person has to be they are duty bound to follow that rule. There are some postulates, there are some jurists who developed the, explain this term much more better and in detail term. And the professor Daithi, whose work is really remarkable in this field, he and one more jurist, Mr. Cook, also they, both of them have worked hard in this particular matter, and they have even, they wrote a book that is called Law and Constitution, in which, in those, in the book of Daithi, in which the Cook's intention was also clearly mentioned, the three terms which we already discussed, the about the three terms which are discussed in earlier session, the same thing is to be in a different manner: supremacy of law, equality before law, and predominance of the legal spirit. Supremacy of the law, it means every person is under the law, either of, irrespective of their position, irrespective of their rank, irrespective of their post, or irrespective of their status. Equality before law, every person is equal before the law. Yani, it means every person of this country have equal protection of law and equal opportunity of the law. And predominance of, whatever the things has been written in the legal books, in the legal, in the act, in the statute, that is, that should be prevail, that should be prevail, none other than the, whatever the words, whatever the phrases, whatever the language used in any act, that is, that have to be predominant, and that is dominating all over the, this is about the postulates. Then now, if you are talking about under Indian constitution, under Indian constitution, as we know, in Article 13, it was clearly means rule of law means rule of law, and if rule of land, law of land, and law of land is constitution, and under the scheme of the constitution, so there are so many acts are framed, and they are under the constitution, and every person of this country is supposed to follow the rule of law. If any person who is deprived by the rule of law, it means the equal protection of law, equality before the law, and predominance of the legal spirit, in that situation, the person have, in these, if any person is denied in the, on these three grounds, these three opportunities, then the person has a right to go to the Supreme Court or the High Court for the enforcement of their right under Article 32 and 226. Under Article 32, the person have a right to approach the Supreme Court. Under Article 226, the person have a right to approach the High Court for the enforcement of those rights or fundamental rights or any other rights for the under the scheme of rule of law. Because the Constitution of India enriched with the principle of justice, equality, and liberty. And these are the part of the preamble of the Constitution also, that justice should not be only done, it seems to be done. So the justice, equality, and liberty is the basic policy of Constitution under the Indian democracy. These things, every law have to conclude this thing, every law which is framed in India must coin this three words: justice, equality, and liberty. There are so many specific cases in which the judiciary time to time define the term a rule of law and different situation. In a very landmark case, ADM Jabalpur case, well-known course of favorable courses, in that particular case, it was told that if the person is in either in the jail or either in the, but no state can deny the fundamental right to have the body. So the person have the right to approach the Supreme Court for the fundamental right. Habeas corpus means to have the body. Every person has a right to approach the Supreme Court and the High Court to get that right, and no person can deprived by the. There are some other case, Somraj versus State of Maharashtra, Union versus India versus Raghubir Singh, case on Bharti case, Menaka Gandhi case, and there are so many case, landmark cases in which the Supreme Court has derived this term and given their decision on the basis of rule of law, on the basis of justice, equality, and the predominance of the legal spirit. So there are many more cases we will get. At last, there is a conclusion. Supremacy of law is the main basic rule of law, and everything if any administrative authority is done under the rule of law or under the supremacy of law, then there might be the least chances of violation of anyone's fundamental right. But still, though it is not perfect and not appropriate, sometimes if administrative authority is doing in personal capacity something and that is beyond the rule of law, that is beyond the person's that influenced by anyone's right, then the person have a right to approach the court under the Article 226 and Article 32. Because rule of law, if you're talking about the rule of law, it's not only constitutional, it also include the human rights also. Human right, the person have a right to live in a proper manner, the person have a right to live and enjoy his or her life. So no one can be deprived, no one can be denied to have such right. This is important things about the rule of law, and that's all for today. This is one of the most important topic, rule of law, that again I conclude my today's lecture or this topic on the three words: justice, equality, and liberty. This is the three main postulates of rule of law. The law, every law should be under these three words. No law is valid. No law is valid if these three words are not here. Okay. So this is it. Thank you so much.